fall in love by the boys. So I just get the little reed drilling with the boys. Yeah. Whoops.
Good luck, Gonzo. What's up, bub? What's that? Yeah, man, I got them all up there, man. I'm pretty upset about Crabtree. He was an 86. Somehow he got dropped down to a 79, got old. Yeah, I didn't use him too much last year, so that's probably why. Change his name. Good luck with your quarterback, dude. I hope I don't put him out. Dude, you know how we play. Every game, every time so far, we always hurting each other.
the end zone. Oh, look at the juke. Oh, now he bowls him over.
Ooh.
And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line.
Man, that play works pretty good, man. I do max protect on that shit and just got one guy doing a fly, and then I got my tight end, or actually I put my fullback in there at that on that play.
Second down here after the incomplete pass. Should be backed up to the 25. It'll be a loss of one, and that'll bring up a 11 situation. The defensive line disperses a little bit here, maybe expecting a pass. Throwing his car on third down. Over the middle complete. It's Kelly. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line.
Come on, man. That's bullshit.
About offense is what you call hidden yardage.
Man, guys, I really want to go for it, but I'm on the 35.
Make a big play. You know, they create a play, run after catch. They did a really nice job there of limiting that.
You can go for it, but it's just, it ain't worth it to me, man.
So on fourth down, here's Marquette King to punt it away.
You don't trust me, huh? Shit, I'm gonna have to do it now. Now that you don't trust me, I'm doing it.
Look here, it's an opening drive fake. And the gamble pays off. They get the first.
I was gonna punt it until you told me you didn't trust me. No, I had to punt picked. I did. But then you said, I don't trust you. So I was like, fuck it. If you don't trust me, I'm gonna do it. I gotta set the tone, man. Fourth and inches on that shit, huh?
They gotta be writing notes to themselves. In practice, work on fake punts right out of the gate because that was really unexpected.
2 yards on the carry there, it'll be second down.
Well, he was looking for some running room, and there wasn't a whole lot of it there on that play. I think he was lucky to get a couple yards out of it because those defenders, they were rallying to the football pretty quickly.
See if they stay on the ground for second down.
He was there too. Damn it.
Houston, Houston. In there to get him for a loss of five.
Sometimes I watch games and wonder why they use play fakes on certain passing situations because it's not going to fool anyone. I don't know if that was the case here, but the end result was the same. No one fooled. Quarterback was hit.
Carr and the Raiders following the sack, looking up at a third and long. Throwing now is Carr. Oh, the pressure too great, and he goes down once more.
Ah, fuck you.
Houston, Houston, in there to pick up his second sack now of the afternoon. On fourth down, here's the Raider punter Marquette King to kick it away. And heavy contact, he is knocked down hard. That'll be put in the books as a 53-yard punt. And the Chiefs are going to take over with a long field ahead and a first and 10.
Let's go! Red 38! Red 38!
And not much there at all. He's up only to about the 16-yard line. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
Well, if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll fire away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. They want to try that again. Go play action, hit them over the top.
And incomplete there.
Oh, you still got Kelsey? Damn, I tried to sign him. I don't know what happened. You just saved some money.
Force the incompletion. That allowed him to get bolder with his pass rush, won't it?
Absolutely. Freeze up your guys elsewhere.
A first carry now for Kareem Hunt. And he'll get it up here this time to the 21. It's a pickup of six.
All right. Good D, baby. Good D.
The punt team's going to be summoned on fourth down.
Nice job there defensively on third down. Not only did they string the play out, but they didn't allow any room for a cutback. Really well organized on the defensive side.
Pilardi now on to punt as he sends this one away. This is taken at the 18. They juked him. And now running right through it. And when it's said and done, it's a 58-yard punt. And the Raiders will take over now first and 10. And now Oakland ready to take the field. And, you know, their previous possession, they were able to move the football, but still wound up punting in the end.
You know, in 2016, Carolina had a 20-play drive that lasted over 10 minutes. And remember how it ended?
In a punt.
I mean, how does that happen? You just don't see that happen every day.
This one maybe not quite that bad, but still, you'd like to have a chance for points if you hold the football that long.
Agreed.
And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
Well, you had the punt on your first drive, and on the first play of the second drive, you end up going backwards. I would dare say they need something good to happen right here, right now.
What are you saying? I'm on the plus side of 30.
But if you're on the plus side of 30, you don't know what I'm on the plus side of. All I know is that run right there, let us know there's still some life in those legs.
Absolutely. Still got a lot of life left in those legs. They get 10 more there, and I believe that'll be enough for another first down. It will.
Now that's often a surprise for the defensive guys when they see the big fella slide out of the backfield and catch the ball. Not something they usually go over in practice very often.
And now whistles and a flag, and I think we got a jump here. And he got a little aggressive too early.
And he did run that quick takeoff as the ball was snapped, but I think sometimes those big guys on offense, they're pretty cagey too, right? They make those little sudden moves or those little subtle moves that get you to jump.
Come on. This time is he'll go down. They got him for a sack.
Well, there's your first ROI, right?
Return. They got to get rid of that ball faster on that shit.
His first NFL sack. I know they want him to be an impact player right out of the gate.
A lot of pressure to put on a young man, but I think you agree he has the ability to deliver on it.
And he just did. Probably the first of many sacks in a long career.
So the defense gets to the quarterback. Now the offense backed up on second down. Gonna throw. He's just gonna dump this one off to his fullback out of the backfield. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down.
And the big guy catches the ball out of the backfield, and oftentimes it's quite a surprise to the guys playing defense because not ordinarily thought as a pass catcher, it often works when they decide to dial it up.
Looking to throw on third and two. And he'll have his man. That's Cooper. And he's able to get the first here as he's taken down at the 25. A Raider first down as Carr finds Cooper.
We've seen quite a bit of the short passing game here early on first quarter, haven't we?
We have, and I think it works a couple of ways for this team.
Damn, how'd he get in there so quick?
On the final play of the first quarter.
Good quarter, brother.
In the second quarter, Brandon Gordon, Charles Davis. It's the Raiders in possession of the football. But they face a second and long to start things out. And now the offense will look to respond after the sack. A second down run for Abdullah. And he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line. That one good for 12 yards. And that'll make it third down.
Look, the first down marker is out there, but sometimes it's hard to find for an offense when they're in a long yardage situation, which usually means throw the football. In this case, they went against the tendency and ran it, and boy, the reward was there. A big, big pickup, and guess what? It's now third and very short in order to try to pick up the first down.
They're going to run it with Abdullah.
Good stuff, man. Damn, I thought I had you tricked up a little bit. It's all good. I guess at least you got to drive the whole field. Good stuff.
Now a play fake here on first down. Dancing to his left.
Nice.
Finds a man on the crossing route. A really good pickup of 28 yards. And the young buck showing that ability, that agility to dance outside of the pocket, complete the deep ball.
And don't think for a second that the coaching staff didn't have their heart rate accelerate a little bit there, right? Anytime you have those young quarterbacks and they get outside of the pocket, you're just hoping that they make good decisions, because so many things can happen that can go wrong when you throw it downfield like that. He got away with it there, and in a big way.
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. He's going to loft one deep left side here. And both guys were there, but it falls incomplete.
And it looked like he had his hands on it for a moment, but let's face it, that was going to be a tough catch all the way because of the presence of the defense right there as he was trying to haul it in.
Yeah, nice job to force the incompletion. So incomplete on second down. Now they'll look to convert here on third.
Damn it, I should have switched that shit. Damn, I should have played that. Good job. Damn.
But nice job there, Charles. They picked up the blitz to complete the pass.
That had a total feel of a quarterback in control. Red Bull got him into rest protection scheme. So he doesn't get hit back, so he's got a chance to step up with supreme confidence and deliver it downfield for a nice completion.
A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
Hey, dude, what's the deal with that other fucking league, man? The Legion of Pigskin. They don't know what the fuck they're doing.
Thank
you. Oh, I'm still in it, but it's like worthless. It's driving me nuts. A bunch of bums, man. They make too many rules because they suck, first off. Way to get on the board. All right, now I got to play legit, make sure I get points. I can't be doing that fourth and one shit.
Field goal range. They just opted not to kick it, didn't get it. How does that change the mentality this go around?
I don't think it changes much for the head coach, because this is what he preaches all the time. Attack at all times in any spot on the field. And he likes touchdowns, not field goals. Now, your field goal kicker, you got to make sure you nurse him through and say, okay, don't worry about it. When we need you, you got to be ready to go. And the team, of course, loves to see points on the board. So let's see if it changes a little bit if they're in the same spot again.
Yeah, we'll see what the decision is here if they get to that spot. Second down following the incompletion.
Fucking Blunt. He's good for one of them a game. Damn you, you suck, Blunt. Fuck. Blunt, you're done.
The organization made a concerted effort in the offseason to improve this defense. I have to say they like the early returns.
That's it. Blunt's done, dude. I'm never using him again. He'll break tackles and shit, but he's damn sure going to get hit in the legs and fumble it. Can't let you run away with this now. Big Papa Dubs coming back. You know that shit. That's how we do this. Boom. That's how we do this. Kickoff return to the Adams.
97 yards. There the Raiders have cut it back to within a score.
I just changed his pamper. Attaboy, Patterson. Dude, I get so many returns with that guy. He's like, he'll break tackles and then he'll go, or it's, he's got weird speed, man. You think it's that? He's got like 91 speed. He's got stamina too, I've noticed. Like on the stretch, he don't slow down. That might be the reason. On the stretch, he don't slow down.
Of two, and it'll be second down. He came out ready to play. That's three tackles for a loss, Charles, rolling the second quarter.
And that's problematic for the guys trying to run offense, because that means he's got a pretty good idea of what they're doing and is actually beating them to the point of attack and making those plays. You might have to think about some misdirection or something to try and get him away from the ball.
In motion left, that's Cooper.
Damn, I had that hole inside.
This offense so far on third down, they've only converted once in four tries. They're looking at a third and goal here.
No.
After just a short pickup. Only a yard there, so it brings up fourth and goal.
This drive started with first and goal. Now that it's fourth and goal, anything less than a touchdown would feel like a letdown to me.
Damn, man, I don't know how you got through all them blockers. Fuck me. Good shit, brother, good shit. That's twice you stuck me on fourth and one, man. Fuck. Yes. It's the only reason why I did it, man, so I can get a safety if I didn't get it.
Didn't get it. Now they've got to put that behind him, try to put together another drive.
Hey, a simple tip of the cap, a nod of the head to the defense. Congratulations, you got us last time. But you didn't hold us the whole time. We got down to position. We were able to be in position to score. Let's go ahead and attack again. Continue to have that kind of confidence. Not worry about the one player that didn't allow him to get into the end zone.
And this time they'll be trying to get it into the end zone. We'll see what they do. Carr now on first down. Steps away to his left. And some room to run now. Nice work to get seven out of that, and it's second down.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
They fake the handoff. Now Carr. And the hit
tied
loose. It's incomplete.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here, he's one that has to absorb the contact, and as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
The Raiders on third down, just 1 for 5 to this point. This time, it's 3rd and 3. Carr going to try and throw on 3rd down. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off near the 42. And a great move again. And they will finally run him down, but not until
fuck. He went all the way back. Damn, he was wide open on the inside, bro. Come on, man. You gotta, you know what I'm saying? Like, shit. Guy was wide open on the inside. You gotta make that catch. You definitely made the catch.
First half of action. The Chiefs on 3rd down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and goal. Back to throw. Four steps.
Fuck you, man. Fuck that. Let's go, Edwards. You're supposed to make that play. You superstar out there. Let's roll. Come on, Gonzo. Shit! Damn! Good shit! Way to make that move, brother! Man, that's my boy right there. Mario, he comes up good usually. You just shaked and baked him, is all.
Blitz is taken at his four. And penalty markers down to the field. And they might be backing up a bit here to start the drive. So the D-line's going to spread out. Carr gives it off to Washington. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets his football out shy of the 30 to the 29. So we've reached halftime here on opening week.
You know, at halftime, they should let you pause it at halftime.
EA Sports Studios in Orlando.
You know what I'm saying?
Here's Larry Ridley.
So if you got any adjustments or anything you need to do at half, you should be able to do it.
He gets past the 25 and up to the 27-yard line. Here comes the Chiefs offensive unit as they'll have it to begin quarter number three. They have the lead, now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters, as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace because you are looking for some separation in this ball game.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt, show them one thing, hit them with something else.
Back to throw now on second and 10. Being chased out left, and he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Khalil Mack in there to sack him for a loss of six. Well, it was second long, now it's third and even longer. They're going in the wrong direction here.
Because they're moving exactly the way they want to, but you're exactly right. Definitely going in the wrong direction for the offensive guys.
Looking to throw. And that is incomplete.
That's pass interference in real life. Yeah, you got to turn your head on that shit.
Run with the receiver and make a play on the football.
Here's Michael Pilardi now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away.
What are you doing? Why wouldn't you catch that? I hate that.
Just outside the 15 at the 16-yard line. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They were able to get the stop defensively, and now a chance to turn that into points on the offensive end.
Can you imagine what the grease board looks like in the half? Because
tell me.
That's exactly what they printed up. Stop them on defense, get the ball back for our offense, and go downfield and score some points. Now, the last part remains to be seen, but they got the first part done very well.
Do people use grease boards, or you mean the magic marker board?
Yeah, those two.
On second down, here's Carr.
Oh, shit.
Over the middle. He's at the 30. 10.
Yes.
Michael Crabtree.
Oh, yeah, dude. Your safety flew down on that shit, dude. Oh, my God.
And correct me if I'm wrong. That was just a simple fly route, wasn't it?
No, there's nothing to correct at all. You got it down pat. And I just remember as a player, when I'd be in practice sessions and I'd hear nine from the receivers, that meant fly route, go. Uh-oh, look out. That was the nine, and he just kept going all the way into the end zone for the touchdown.
This is Field a couple yards deep. And the decision to bring it out, a good one, as he's up a yard or two shy of the 30. Now the Chiefs offense, they get ready to head on the field. Certainly want to avoid what they had to do last possession. That was punt the football, because this game's starting to tighten up.
In a basketball sense, you think about taking a little bit of the air out of the ball, right? Maybe milk some clock, limit the possessions. In this case, they might want to do the same thing, but control the game offensively. Put together some first downs, put together a drive, and keep it away from them.
Now a handoff running off tackle right. And some space here.
That's my fuck up, man. God darn it. Damn it, man. I can't believe that shit. Where's my player? I don't understand where my safety is. I got some backup safety in there for some reason. Hopefully,
probably tired, bro.
Probably. But I wasn't even able to look at him. I mean, not here. What the fuck? Shit, they're there. Why the hell ain't they in there?
Ready?
Yeah, I'm ready. Nah, that shit ain't happening again.
And this will get out of bounds. No worries there, though. That still goes as a touchback. The Raiders offense now, they trot back out. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Throwing on first down, it's Carr. To the sideline, wow, what a catch. Doesn't get a lot out of it. But he is able to keep the feet in bounds. It'll be a 3-yard gain, and that'll make this a second down. And not much, maybe a yard up to the 29.
Sometimes with a running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
Fuck, man.
Tyler Davison in there to get him his second sack now of the afternoon.
Brandon, I think you understand the type of afternoon this offensive line is having. It is a long one for them. Long for you to spend it with me. Long for them trying to block those guys. They've given up a whole lot of sacks, and the speed and quickness that defensive line is eating them alive.
Take it in at the 22.
Fucking fumble, man.
That one back, 14 on the return. And it's Chiefs football, first and 10. Down. He's going to loft one deep left side here. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. Well, they haven't had a whole lot of success in the passing game here. Now in the second half, he's thinking, I guess maybe just take a shot deep.
I think you're right. Almost looking for a bailout, isn't he? Can my receiver go up and make a big play for me? Can I create a penalty downfield, maybe pick up an interference call and get that yardage downfield? Anything trying to get going again, but you're right. He definitely took a shot.
On third down, that's Hunt. No gain on the play there. A nice job defensively, and it likely forces a punt situation on fourth. So nothing there, but maybe you blame that on the blocking.
Yeah, at some point, you've got to win at the point of attack, and on that play, that was all the defense. They made it happen.
On is the punt team now as this one sent away. That'll be a 44-yard boot, just a yard on the return as he's covered up quickly. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs.
Right.
outside catch by Crabtree. And down he'll go at the 25. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
He decided to run a hitch route. It really helped to have a guy who can turn it loose. And boy, he rifled one in there on that one. Not much run after catch.
Fuck, man. Come on. You got to make that block, big boy.
This has been a familiar sight all afternoon as they stop in behind the line.
It's really easy to say this running game needs to be better, but the reality is they've been given little time to actually find a place to run the football. It's almost like the defense is there on the handoff.
Favorite, you need this tablet anymore.
The Raiders on third down. It's been a problem. Just 1 for 7 thus far. This is 3rd and 4. From the gun, it's Carr.
Holy shit, man!
Marquette King now, as he's on to punt for Oakland. This is away and a very good kick angled for the sidelines. And this punt goes out of bounds and it'll be marked inside the 40. So now here are the Chiefs as their offense makes their way back out onto the field. This crew had to punt last time they had the ball, but when you've got a lead like this, you content to play the field position game?
You are to an extent, especially if you like your defense, because you have the lead, you've been controlling the game. But why put them in a tougher spot? You want to get out there and get something done on offense and maybe take command of this game yourself.
Now a handoff here to his running back. Trying to find a lane, but instead he'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and no more. No gain on the play, it'll be 2nd down. Then he got off the end there very quickly to make that play.
That was almost like the bullet train, wasn't it? I mean, just boom, quick, and what a terrific play, holding them to no gain.
And here's another tackle made at the line, so they're converging well on the football now. Kind of running there at your own risk against that 4-3 in that big line, aren't you?
Yeah, and I don't really run it against a good 4-3 team that well because I've got to get those guys on the move a little bit. If you're a static running team, meaning you just want to run it in the middle, you may have some trouble against good defensive tackles. That's what we just saw on that play. No gain.
Now back to throw. Going up top. And that one incomplete. Had some position but couldn't hold on, and it brings up 4th down.
Damn, man, it's good defense on this half.
It's almost a surprise to see an incomplete pass on 3rd down, isn't it?
Yeah, they have had their foot on the gas all game long, but here finally stalling out. His first punt, 45 yards. This looks good as well. And this will pin him nicely inside the 20 as it's out of bounds at about the 14-yard line. And now Oakland ready to take the field. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. And they begin the drive with a duel. And strong running there gets this up over the 15-yard line. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it 2nd down.
I'd say they've got to find a way to get him going. He's such a big part of their offense. I wonder if they might throw it a little and come back to the run.
Anything, because you're right. He's pretty much been completely neutralized. And he'll be about a full yard shy of the 20 at the 19-yard line. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's 3rd down. To throw his car. Buying time to his left. And avoids the contact by sliding. Carr can beat you in a lot of ways. The scramble there, a perfect example as he gets the first.
When they watch film of this game and hand out the grade sheets, he's going to really like getting a double plus on this play. Why?
And he's going to lose yardage.
Fuck, man. I tried to go big, man. Blew it.
No press coverage here. They are backing off in the secondary. And he's going to go down again. Tyler Davidson able to disrupt. disrupt yet another pass play, his third sack of the afternoon. Carr and the Raiders following the sack, looking up at a third and long. Intercepted. Picked off around the 37. Wow, evasive.
Make a miss.
And that pick just sets him up beautifully right down near the goal line.
I remember being in a defensive meeting back when I was in college, and our defensive coordinator says, we're going to call this be who you are defense. D-lineman, you play the run. Linebackers, be aware of anything. And secondary, you play the pass. That way, you're all set, ready for whatever they put out there.
Only a yard that time, second and goal. Got to figure now, after getting that turnover, they're just going to be happy to keep the ball on the ground, right?
This is where covering the football, taking care of the ball, all the ball security terms that have ever been used, they come into play for the guys on offense right now. Just take care of it, and they've got a good chance of ending up winning this game.
Gonna give this time to the tailback. And he's gonna ball his way into the end zone for a Chiefs touchdown. A great effort there, making quite a splash with his second touchdown in his NFL debut. And the Chiefs use the short advantage as they for six.
All right, man, that's where everything gets shifted right there, brother.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This is taken at his four.
No! My slow-ass motherfuckers.
For a quick second there, I thought we were about to have a repeat performance of a kickoff return for a touchdown.
That was good, though.
I know. I already ran one back today on this one. About to get another one.
Check in with our referee. On first and 10, here's Carr. A double from Doyle. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. That one will go as a gain of 11. Raiders having a first down as well. At this stage, this drive's got to be touchdown or bust because you need two.
And if I'm the offensive play caller, I'm not just looking at my dagger plays downfield. I'm looking at some of my specials, something that can fool and give you a big play now.
With a sense of urgency.
No doubt.
A solid pickup of 13 sets him up first and goal. In motion, Patterson. On first down, Carr. And he's going to be taken down.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
Carr to throw on second down. And this is Carr.
Yes!
Touchdown, Raiders. Michael Crabtree, already his second touchdown here in this opening weekend. And the Raiders are back within a score. He's got it up and through. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. And the Chiefs now getting set to go. Some good games around the league here early in week one, and this one shaping up to be as good as any of them as we come up on a first and 10. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he is able to plow forward up to about the 29, just shy of the 30. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down.
Brandon, you know how many times we've done games, and at the start of the fourth quarter, we see both teams hold up the four fingers, fourth quarter is ours. Well, how about this drive? You saw the four fingers for four-minute offense, and this offensive line has really hunkered down and established themselves.
And look at this. They get the turnover they needed.
Yes, that was usable, baby. Let's go. Bad throw, Carr. Yeah, it wasn't. You weren't gonna get that one. That was a bad throw by Carr. It was supposed to go to the outside guy coming on a cut in.
Because so many parts come together to make it work well. The offensive linemen, where they're faking people out, the back slipping out there, catching the football, then all of them going together as one unit downfield. A really nice pickup.
On first down, Abdullah. Got a pretty big hole as he's down to about the 40. Just what you want on a first down run, call it 8 yards, and it's second and two.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, gotta like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely. Pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
And this time, not quite to the 30. It'll be down at the 31-yard line. 9 yards on the pick up there, and it keeps the drive alive. And let's see what the defensive coordinator may have up his sleeve here to try to get this final last stand and win this football game. Now whistles here, I believe one of the Raider linemen might have been moving. And that'll be accepted, of course, and that moves him back five. And this will probably be the final play before the two-minute warning. Shotgun now to Carr. Out to the flat. That's complete to his running back.
Damn it, wait a second. I got a good play.
Losing yardage back near the 40 at the 39. That'll set him back with a loss of three on the play. And it'll be a second and long. Time for a break. We'll come back for the electrifying conclusion after this. Defense really showing respect to the deep ball now and both the receivers. Got a complete to Crabtree. And this time not quite to the 30. It'll be down at the 31-yard line. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down.
It drives some people crazy to see those short throws underneath. They gotta find a way to gash the defense downfield.
The Raiders on third down. Just a 20% success rate at 2 of 10. This is third and 10. Back to throw. He goes underneath to Abdullah.
Tied up. Too much time, but tied up. That's all that matters.
31 yards. And the Raiders, they're within an extra point of tying this thing up. Well, the hard part's done. Now they just need to split the post, tie it up, but then their defense is going to have to hold up to send it to overtime.
Yeah, no matter what. I know there's an inclination in it when you have momentum to go for two here. But if you miss it, you don't give your defense a chance at all.
Plus, it's been a good game. I want to see overtime. I'm selfish.
You obviously don't have a flight to catch. Tomorrow.
And now here comes Kansas City. We have seen a lot of points here in this quarter. For us up here in the booth, it's been fun to watch. The defensive coordinators probably scratching their heads.
Yeah, they're going a little bit crazy right now. But let's face it, all of our friends who play fantasy, they're enjoying the heck out of this show because most of them are creating and getting a bunch of points.
Points certainly not at a premium here. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Melvin Ingram able to drop him for a loss of four. And they weren't in zone coverage. They were in man, and each man did his job.
And that looked like vintage, old-school coverage, didn't it? Man coverage reminded me of an old Raiders team. They had a Hall of Famer at one corner and a Defensive Player of the Year at the other, and they just locked people down.
Offense needs something here on second down. It is second and long. They'll look to throw. Now they go screen. It's complete. And down he'll go at the 25. Now whistles, and the Raiders are going to signal for a timeout. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. The Chiefs on third down, lacking much success, just 2 for 7 to this point. This is third and 10. Back to throw here. He'll air it out deep for Thomas. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked up by Gary and Conley. And his guys are going to take over at the 34-yard line. So how about a momentum switch?
We're in the fourth quarter and it's a tie game. You've got to take care of the football here. Now their opportunity to take the lead right out the window, and everything is flipped in the other direction.
And he'll work this one up to about the 38. And give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and 6. Clock now under 30 ticks and running. Now Carr. He completes it to Abdullah. A pickup of 10, and it's enough for an Oakland first down.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
Come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense.
Almost.
As it'll come with 15 seconds.
One more 15, 20-yard pass. Come in.
Here's Abdullah running deep. And he'll take it down to the 30-yard line. Now a final chance to stop it here as a timeout comes in with 10 seconds left in the game.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not
too sure. Yes!
Damn, you got
it. That's that win, baby. Got lucky. Yeah! Good shit, man. Good game, John. Run this bitch back, dude. I want to see a friggin' game of a lifetime.
They get ready to head on the field. Look at the clock. Everyone knows the situation. Probably time here for one final play.
And we know what that play is going to be. It's got to be some sort of Hail Mary, throwing it towards the end zone and hoping someone can catch it or catch it off of a tip.
And the Raiders have got him. A costly sack. They'll have to use a timeout here. And barring a defensive penalty, they'll be looking at
one hell of a game, bro. I want them to friggin' score, kind
of. And no press coverage here. They are backing off in the secondary. He'll look to throw.
Oh, pass the line.
Damn, he got lucky there, huh?
Now he crossed the line anyways, but shit. Good-ass game, brother. That was one hell of a game, Gons. That was it. That was legit right there. One heck of a game. One of the best games I've played in a long time. Came back
you from, always play. It's always a good game.
From 14-point deficit. with that comeback special on him. You know it's Big Dub when it comes down to the big time comeback special.